Good evening, folks. Well, on tonight's blog, I actually have two things I want to talk about. First, for the big announcement, or a couple of days ago, or after giving it or quite a bit of thought, but having had such amazing results with P90X, or I have decided to become a Team Beachbody independent coach. Which means if you have any fitness goals or questions, once you want to live healthier, or order some Shakeology, whatever it is, I can help you. All you have to do is just say, hey, I need help, and tell me what you need help with, and I will be right there with all the answers you need. And if for some reason you have a question I can't answer, I'll find an answer for you and get back with you. It's like guaranteed. So I'm here to help you. Right. And the second would be the topic of tonight's blog, or is the scale or body fat percentage, or what does it all mean? Well, a lot of folks are unfortunately go by the FDA standard, and the FDA standard is skewed at best. Now, for instance, or the body mass index that they have, if you went by the body mass index, or I would be considered overweight, even as lean as I am, we're at a roughly 9.3% body fat. Say I weigh 170 pounds as of this vlog. And quite honestly, does that look like or look like I'm overweight at all, if you can see that? No, of course not. That's because the FDA does not take into account a lot of stuff or in their standards. So, like according to FDA, I should weigh 150 pounds. But I obviously don't. So, but before I went in the military, I weighed 155 pounds, but my body fat percentage was a lot higher. We're talking around 17% body fat, and it showed. Granted, in the military, I actually got in worse shape than what I went in with, but I did put on a lot of muscle mass in that time. So, that having been taken into account, once I started losing weight when I was 223 pounds and 24% body fat, I came down to 183 pounds. That was a lot leaner than 155 pounds I went into the military with. And my body fat percentage was about 4% lower than what I went in the Army with. The composition plays a big part of how healthy you really are, not your weight. Now, granted, your weight is a factor in it, but it is not the most important factor. The scale itself, it is important if you're aiming to lose weight or gain weight, because it will tell you a lot, but you have to know how to listen to what it's telling you. Because if you just go by the scale alone, you have no idea, am I gaining body fat or am I gaining muscle? Well, that's where you got to have a general idea of what your body fat percentage is. So if you know what your body fat percentage is, or that scale becomes a valuable tool. Well, I know a lot of you are asking, well, how can I measure my body fat accurately? Well, the most accurate way that, unfortunately, most folks like me cannot afford is underwater weighing. You have to go to a special facility wherein they weigh you literally underwater. But, like I said, I can't afford that, even though that is the gold standard, ideally. But there are a lot of other options out there. Well, one option you might find locally is what they call a bod pod. Basically, based on your breathing or how much you weigh within the chamber, it'll tell you what your body fat percentage is down to about 1%. So if it's plus or minus 1%, it's dang accurate. I can't stress that enough. I know there's not a bod pod anywhere near where I live, so I have to use other options. Now, if you're just starting out, you really don't know, what do I need to use it? Well, they have these scales or analyzers that are handheld that will send an electrical impulse through your body and measure your body fat. Now, these I have to stress against because they are not really accurate. All they will do is get you roughly in the ballpark of where you're currently at. Well, aside from the fact that I don't really like the idea of it sending electrical impulse through my body. It can be affected by how much water you've drunk that day, or it can be affected of whether or not you're actually an athlete or just an everyday user of it. Not to mention the battery power. You have to replace batteries in those constantly, so if it gets low battery, that'll give you a bad reading too. But if you're just starting out, that'll get you in the ballpark roughly, and they're accurate to plus or minus 5%. Those you can buy almost anywhere. Just go up there to a local Walmart or go to a GNC, you can find them. The second most accurate is going by your measurements. Now, for most of you that are about midway through your journey or you're still early on, this is going to be your most accurate method. Now, you don't want just a tape measure or something like that you'd use to or measure a 2x4 to cut. You want a tailored nylon. Well, it's not nylon. I forgot what the actual material is, but it's one of these kind. You see? Alright, it doesn't bend, it doesn't stretch. You can fold it up like that occasionally and sit on it, it'll stick that way, but that's not really hurting you. Now, the reason you want one of these is because it's not stretching. If it stretches, it won't give you an accurate reading, and it definitely will not tell you what you need to know. So it'll give you a false reading. The reason the measurements are important is, early on, they will tell you a lot of what you need to know. If your measurements are going up, or your weight's staying the same, chances are you're putting on a lot of lean muscle. But if your weight's going down and your measurements are staying the same, or that also means you're putting on lean muscle. Now if your weight's going up and your measurements are going up, you might not be doing it right. And if both are going down, you are losing weight, though you might be losing muscle mass and fat at the same time. But this will tell you a lot of what you need to know, and it'll get you to, and if you use it to, or to do the tape measurements for your body fat, it'll get you to plus or minus about 3% for either way. For most people that really aren't super hardcore into fitness, that's a perfect option for you. Now, aside from the fact it's cheap, you can find it or any clothing store, or almost any or tailor clothing store or fabric store. So you can find them for any of those places. Now, next to underwater weighing, the most accurate method to get your body fat is a caliper. Like this one from AccuFitness. You can easily pick these up from GNC. And they're foolproof because they have these right here. When it snaps down like this, you've applied enough pressure on the caliper to get an accurate measure from the fold. Based on the millimeter measurement, which is the inside one here, that will tell you what your body fat percentage is based on the measurements from that. But here's the catch of the caliper. You've got to know how to do it correctly. It's recommended that you do it at least 2 or 3 times to make sure you can get a consistent reading with it, with a plus or minus about 1 millimeter from your at least the same reading twice in a row. But really, if you're about 1 or 2 meters or 1 or 2 millimeters off for each time, based on or roughly within that range from that 1 millimeter mark that you get consistently, you're still good. But I strongly recommend you either get a personal trainer or a doctor or a nutritionist who has more experience with the caliper to show you what sites to use or how to accurately measure when using the caliper. If you don't know what you're doing, it'll still give you a bad reading too. But if you're doing it correctly, you're doing it in the right spots, or you're using the right calculators, or it will be plus or minus 1.1% either direction. If you use an online calculator to calculate your body fat percentage using any of those methods, or using the tape measure or the caliper, you have to be careful on what calculator you're using. Now, if you're going to use a calculator, I strongly recommend that you use a teambeachbody.com. So you sign up for a free membership in the Wowie Gym, and it'll give you all sorts of tools like that, including or a body fat calculators based on caliper readings or measurements. So it's a really handy site. I highly recommend it because it's got a lot of useful tools that you can use. All right, there are other websites out there too where they have calculators, but they may or may not be as accurate. Because not any two sites use the same formula. But once you start getting measurements and you start using a particular site, use that particular site for all of your measurements. Because that way, even if it's not giving you accurate measurements, it's still giving you the change over time that you need to know. Say if TeamBeachBody.com, you was measured at 20% body fat, and at another site, you was measured at 22%, and you put the same measurements in, and it's giving you about the same drop, but you know you've lost that percentage of your body fat. So that's still good information to know, even if it's not 100% accurate. But if you're one of those people who wants to do it by hand, you can find the formulas again at teambeachbody.com, or you can find 100 articles on bodybuilding.com or to give you the same formulas. Me, I don't like to do the math that much, so I plug it into the calculators where I know I'm going to use consistently. And that's where I get my measurements or what I've changed over time. So, say again. Then I'm a Beachbody coach, so if you need my help and figure any of this out or got any questions, just let me know. Then, or I'll include the web address to my Beachbody sites in my Wowie Gym profile, so you see my background, see where I'm coming from. And if you want me to be your coach, just sign up under me or let me know, or a comment or a personal message, and I will definitely give you all the knowledge I can. And no matter what war you're fighting, whether it's in Iraq, Afghanistan, or you're fighting the war on obesity, knowledge is power. If you know the right thing to do, it's like you're far better equipped than that person who knows nothing. But if you are one of those people that knows nothing and you're willing to admit, I don't know how to do this, and you want to find out and ask questions, then you are starting off on the right path. Well, good night, folks, and see you next time.